just to know you. I wasn't a threat to the devil.
Come on.
You wouldn't waste his time.
Yeah.
Interfere with my life.
All right.
If I wasn't special to God,
come on, Earl.
How would I know what he's willing to do for me?
Preach.
We know what he's.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. This is God's servant, Tammy Carter, with Fire Deliverance Ministries. And I want to share a vision that our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, showed me. And I do believe that is pertaining to DMX Soul. Now, first off, I do want to say, I'm not saying DMX is in heaven. I'm not saying DMX is in hell. But I'm going to let you know what the Lord showed me. Hallelujah. I also want to state that, you know, the enemy has deceived so many people in believing that Christians are people that are full of hate, that Christians are people that want others to go to hell, and that they are very judgmental. And I'm here to let you know that's not true. Christians follow Christ, and Christians have to speak what thus saith the Lord. Hallelujah. We have to speak the truth, because it's the truth. That's the only thing that can set people free. A lie cannot set anyone free. It has to be the truth. If you ever want to see anyone set free, your family, your friends, your enemies, you have to tell them the truth. You can't look at someone and know the truth as far as you know that person is in captivity. I'm not talking about your opinion. I'm not talking about your feelings and your emotions. No, we're talking about Jesus Christ's truth, because he is the truth. Hallelujah. There are so many people that have family members, and you know that they are dealing with demonic possession, and you are afraid to tell them the truth because you don't want to offend them. I'm here to let you know, people are going to get mad about the truth. Hallelujah. But that don't mean that you didn't plant the seed. Hallelujah. And their blood is no longer on your hand. We got to cry loud and spare not. Hallelujah, because we do it in love. As Jesus said, he did not come to condemn the world, but he came to save the world, that the world might be saved through him. So that's what we got to understand, that it's in speaking the truth, in which that's the only thing Jesus did. That's all he did, was speak the truth. Let me tell you what it's going to take to enter into my kingdom, my Father's kingdom. That's all he was saying. Hallelujah. But because man, hallelujah, got jealous, they became jealous, and they didn't want the people to turn from them to Jesus. Hallelujah. Then they wanted to attack what he was saying and saying it was false. But I'm here to let you know that Jesus Christ is the King of the world. He is the truth. And we got to understand, the only way that we can make it in this life is by following Jesus. We cannot, hallelujah, be straddling the fence in the world, want to be in God. We got to choose a side. And at this time, I'm going to tell you about what the Lord showed me. So I think it was on a Friday. This could have been last Friday. Yes, it was last Friday. I was out doing deliveries. And while I was out doing deliveries, I said, you know, I'm going to listen to something, because normally I don't listen to a lot of things that's not pertaining to Christ. I also don't watch television. So I was scrolling on YouTube, just looking to see what I could come across. And I came across the documentary on DMX. I think also I could have watched an interview first. So I believe after I watched the interview, I began to watch the documentary on DMX. So I watched that for hours while I was out driving and working. And so the next day, the Lord brought me a vision, a dream. And in the dream, I was out driving, doing deliveries just like I was doing the day before when I was watching the documentary. And also in the dream, I saw some family members and they were like cooking. And it was my aunt, her daughter, and I believe it was my uncle in the dream. So they were cooking. And then I went into like the back of the house outside. And when I did that, I saw a big ditch. And when I saw the ditch, I looked inside the ditch and I seen two boys. One boy, he was further down in the ditch and he was playing in the mud. And then I saw one of the boys who was like on the side of the ditch, but he still was inside the ditch. And so as I was looking at them, all of a sudden the water began to fill the ditch just like that in an instant. And when the water filled the ditch, the water was jet black. And I saw one of the boys that was on top of, you know, on the ground level where I was. And that appeared to be the boy that was further inside the ditch down playing in the mud. And then I saw, I was looking inside the ditch for the other boy because he wasn't up on the land surface as we were. But I seen like bubbles like that were floating up from the water. Now, mind you, once again, the water was black. All of a sudden, my body was thrown inside the water. And so as I'm going down, because it was deep, really, really deep. So as I was going down, I was thinking to myself, okay, this is my time. I'm getting ready to die. That's what I said in my mind as I was thinking, going down in the water. And all of a sudden, I began to float back up, coming up out of the, again, black water. But in the water, I seen the boy. And when I saw the boy, he was bent over like he was dead. He did not float up to the top. He just was in one spot, but I seen him inside the water. Now, as I'm looking and I'm coming up out the water, now I'm looking from a different view because at this moment, I see my spiritual man coming up. Hallelujah. And he was coming up as a Caucasian male. Now, mind you, again, that's me coming up out the water. And I'm looking at him coming up. So when he came up, he was trying to crawl back up on top of the soil to come up out the water. And then at one point when he was trying to come up, he slipped back in. Now, he never reached out to help the boy. So then I seen ropes coming across the water. They were coming across the ditch. And I seen my spirit man grab the ropes and he swung himself up on the sand on the soil so he can come out the water, in which that's what happened. So let me say this. I'm like, Lord, what are you saying? And it was to me like he was letting me know that there were no lifelines for that soul. Because one thing I can say, I had been praying for DMX. I had been asking God to forgive him of his sins. Hallelujah, that he would deliver him. Because I know that God is a deliverer. He can deliver you in this life. He can deliver you on your deathbed. And I had been praying that God will deliver him, whether he was to come back to health or whether God would deliver him before he passed. And the Lord brought me this dream. And I said, oh, my Lord God, There was no lifeline. To me, the ropes represented a lifeline. There was no help for the boy that was in the black water. There was no reaching out to him. Hallelujah. Even when I came up, that I would grab him, or even when I seen my spirit man come up, there was no help for that soul. Hallelujah. And I believe. Hallelujah. My recording stopped. But I believe, with that being said, that that soul did not make it. And again, the only thing I'm going to share with you is what God showed me. So, people of God, know today, love the Lord, serve the Lord with everything in you, serve Him and Him alone. Hallelujah. You have to pick a side, because you cannot serve two masters. Jesus loves you. The woman of God loves you. I love what Jesus loves. I love souls. Hallelujah. And I'm just like the Father, that none should perish. Hallelujah. And so that's my testimony on what the Lord showed me. And I want you to know today that we cannot make it through this world, make it through this life without Jesus. We are up against an unseen adversary. And the only way that we can fight him is that we got to be led by Christ, and we got to walk in the Spirit, because he's going to go before us. He's going to fight for us. Hallelujah. He's going to keep us. He's going to cover us. Don't you know Jesus loves his own? Hallelujah. And he's not going to let the enemy harm us or hurt us or destroy us, because we belong to him. Well, people of God, know today, Jesus loves you, and the woman of God loves you. Amen.